Hello everyone, welcome to CAD/CAM tutorials. In this video, we are going to create a ball bearing assembly using the Creo Parametric software. You can see the same assembly on the screen right now. So now let's begin it. So let us first close it. Then we'll go for File, Manage Sessions, and select here Erase Not Displayed. Now again we'll go for File, Manage Sessions, and then select here Erase Current, and select all the parts and OK. Now we'll start our assembly. Before making assembly, we'll create one working directory so that all the parts that we'll create will be in a single folder. And for that, we'll go for Select Working Directory. Select here Desktop. Now right click here and create a new folder and name the folder as Ball Bearing. And OK. Now we'll go for a new file. Select here part and uncheck here use default templates. OK. And here we'll select solid part millimeter kg second. OK. Now we'll make all the datums visible. Then we'll go for sketch and select here the right plane. Sketch and sketch view. Now here we'll draw two concentric circles like this. Now here this inner circle is of dia 74 and outer one is of 90. Now we'll exit the sketch. Then we'll go for extrude and here we'll select mid plane and enter depth as 23 mm. OK. Now here we'll select shading with edges. Then we'll go for sketch and select here the top plane, sketch and sketch view. Now first we'll insert a horizontal center line over here. Then we'll go for circle and draw one circle on this line like this. Now the distance of center of circle from this horizontal center line, that is 32.5 mm, and the diameter of circle is 15 mm. Now we'll exit the sketch and we'll go for roll feature and here we'll select remove material. OK. Now we'll go for round and enter radius as 1 mm. Then select here this edge and this edge. OK. Now we'll go for chamfer and enter here chamfer distance as 0.5 mm. Then select here this edge and this edge. OK. Now our part is completed. Now we'll assign material. So select here enter part, go for view, appearance, and here we'll select chrome. So select here standard chrome. Now we'll save it. So we'll go for file, save as, and name it as outer as, and OK. Now we'll go for the second part. So we'll go for file, new, and select here part, uncheck here use default templates, and OK. And select here solid part millimeter kg second. OK. Now first we'll go for sketch and select here this right plane, sketch and sketch view. Now here we'll draw two concentric circles like this. Now inner circle is of dia 40 mm and the outer one is of 56. Now we'll exit the sketch and we'll go for extrude. Now here we'll select mid plane, enter depth as 23 mm and OK. Now we'll go for sketch and select here this top plane, sketch and sketch view. Now here also we'll insert a center line horizontal center line like this. Then again we'll go for circle and draw one circle on this line like this. Now here also the distance is 32.5 mm, and the diameter of circle is 15 mm. Now we'll exit the sketch and we'll go for roll. Now here also we have to select remove material and okay. Now again we'll go for round and select here round radius as 1 mm, and then here we'll select this edge and this edge, okay. Now again we'll go for chamfer, enter here chamfer distance as 0.5 mm, and then here select this edge and this edge, okay. Now the second part is completed and we'll assign material. So select here entire part, go for view, appearance, and here also we'll select standard chrome. Now we'll save it. So go for file, save as, and here name it as inner res and okay. Now we'll go for the third part, and for that we'll go for file, new, select here part and uncheck here use default templates, okay. And here we'll select solid part millimeter kg second, okay. Now first we'll go for sketch and select here this right plane, sketch and sketch view. Now here first we'll insert one vertical center line. So we'll go for center line and insert center line like this. Then we'll go for line and we'll draw one vertical line like this. Now the length of entire line is of 3 mm, and this is half of that, that is 1.5, and the entire line is of 3 mm. Now the distance between this line and this vertical center line, that is 1.5 mm. Now again we'll go for line and we'll complete the sketch. Now here this distance is of 1 mm, this vertical distance is of 1 mm, and here this entire distance is of 5 mm. Now the sketch is completed, so we'll exit the sketch. We'll go for the roll, okay. Now we'll go for the round and enter radius as 0.5 mm. Now select here this upper edge and this lower edge, okay. Now the part is completed and we'll assign the material. So select here entire part, we'll go for the view, appearance, and select here standard chrome. Now we'll go for file, save as, and we'll name it as rivet and okay. Now we'll go for the fourth part. So we'll go for file, new, and select here part, uncheck here use default templates and okay. And here we'll select solid part millimeter kg second, okay. Now first we'll go for sketch and select here this top plane, sketch and sketch view. Now here we'll insert one horizontal center line like this. Now we'll go for circle and we'll draw one circle over here. Now the diameter of circle is 15 mm. Now we'll go for line and we'll draw one line over here. Now we'll go for delete segment and we'll delete these segments. Now the sketch is completed, so we'll exit the sketch. We'll go for the revolve and okay. Now here in the center of this sphere, we'll insert one point. So we'll go for point. Select here the surface of the sphere, and here we'll select center. Okay. Now we'll give it appearance. So select here entire part. Go for view, appearance, and select here standard chrome. Now we'll save it. So we'll go for file, save as, and we'll name it as ball. And okay. Now we'll go for the last part. So we'll go for file, new, and select here part. Uncheck here use default template, and okay. And here we'll select solid part millimeter kg second. Okay. Now first we'll go for sketch, and we'll select here the top plane, sketch, and sketch view. Now here first we'll insert one horizontal center line. So select here center line and draw one center line like this. Then we'll go for circle and we'll draw two concentric circles like this. Now this inner circle is having dia of 15 mm and the outer circle is having dia of 18 mm. Now the distance of center of circle from this vertical center line, that is 32.5 mm. Now we'll go for line and we'll draw one horizontal line like this. Then we'll go for delete segment and we'll delete these segments. Now our sketch is completed, so we'll exit the sketch and we'll go for revolve feature. Now here enter angle of revolution as 180 and okay. Now we have to make 8 such features. So select here this revolve feature, go for the pattern. Now here we'll select axis pattern and select y axis for the pattern. Now here we have to make 8 such pattern, so enter here 8 and select here this angle button and okay. Now again we'll go for sketch and select here the top plane, sketch, and sketch view. Now here we have to draw two concentric circles like this. Now the inner circle is having dia of 58 mm and the outer circle is having dia of 72 mm. Now we'll exit the sketch and we'll go for extrude. Now here we'll select remove material and we'll select here this toggle button. And okay. Now again we'll go for sketch and select here this top plane, sketch, and sketch view. Now here also we have to draw two concentric circles like this. Now we'll exit the sketch and we'll go for extrude. Now here the depth of extrusion is 1.5 mm and okay. Now again we'll go for sketch and select here the top plane, sketch, and sketch view. Now here also we have to insert one horizontal center line like this. Then we'll go for circle and we'll draw one circle over here like this. Now the diameter of circle is 15 mm and the center distance from this vertical center line is 32.5 mm. Then here we'll select the line and we'll draw one horizontal line like this. Then we'll go for delete segment and delete this portion. Then we'll exit the sketch and we'll go for revolve feature and we'll select here remove material. Okay. Now we have to make 8 such pattern, so select here this revolve, go for the pattern and select here the axis pattern. Now here select y axis for pattern, select here this y axis and select here number as 8, and select here this angle button and OK. Now again we'll go for sketch and select here this top plane, sketch and sketch view. Now here first we'll insert a center line like this. Then we'll go for dimensions, select here the center line, select the horizontal center line and press your scroll button. Now here this angle is 22.5 degree. Then we'll go for circle and we'll create one circle on the center line like this, and the diameter of circle is 3 mm. Then we'll go for dimensions, select here center point of circle and select here the origin and press your scroll button. Now this distance is 32.5 mm. Now we'll exit the sketch and we'll go for extrude and select here remove material and select here through all. Okay, now select here dead cut extrude, go for the pattern and select here the axis pattern, and then select here y axis for pattern, and here number of pattern is 8, and select here this angle button and OK. Now we'll apply rounds, so select here round and enter round radius as 1.5 mm, and then select here all these edges one by one. Make sure that you select all the edges. Now we'll click on OK. Now we'll assign material. So select here entire part, go for the view, appearance, and select here this brass. Now we'll save it, so we'll go for file, save as, and we'll name it as gauge, and OK. So till now we have created all the parts, and now we'll make assembly from all these parts, and for that we'll go for file, new, and make sure that you select here assembly. And uncheck here use default template and OK. And here we'll select millimeter kg second assembly design and OK. Now first we'll go for assemble and we'll select here this inner race and open. Now for the inner race we'll go for the default placement. OK. Now again we'll go for assemble and we'll go for outer race and open. Now here first we'll select here this face and then select here this face, and for that we'll go for coincident. Now after that select here this cylindrical surface and this cylindrical surface and make it here coincident. Now we'll click on OK. After that we'll go for assemble and we'll go for cage and open. Now here we'll select here this flat surface, and after that select here right plane of this inner or outer edge, and here we will select the coincident. Now after that, select here the cylindrical portion or the surface, and then select here this cylindrical surface. Now we'll click on OK. Now we have to insert the balls, and for that we'll go for assemble, select here ball and open. Now here we'll select this curved surface of the cage, and then select here curved surface of the ball, and here we'll select centered and OK. Now we have to make the pattern for the balls. So here we'll select here ball, then we'll go for the pattern, and here we'll select the axis pattern. Now here for the axis, we'll select here this axis and enter number of member as 8, and select here this angle button. Okay. Now we'll go for the assemble and select here the cage and open. Now select here this face of the cage, like this face, and then select here this face of the cage and make it here coincident. Now after that, here we have to select here this cylindrical surface of this rivet, and then select here this cylindrical surface and make it here coincident. Now after that, here select this cylindrical surface, and then select here this cylindrical surface, and here also make it coincident, and click on OK. Now after that, we have to insert the rivets, and for that we'll go for the assemble and select here rivet, open. Now first we'll make all the datums hide. Now here we'll select here this cylindrical portion, and then select here this cylindrical portion. Now select here this face of the rivet, and then select here this face and make it here coincident. Now click on OK. Now after that, we'll make pattern for the rivets. So select here rivet, go for the pattern, and here we'll go for the axis pattern, and here we'll select here this axis for the pattern. Now enter here number of member is 8, and select here this angle button and OK. Now we'll make all the datums hide. Now our assembly is completed, and for the better appearance, we'll go for the render studio. So we'll go for the applications and select here render studio. Now here we'll go for scene, edit scene, and in the background we'll select here color and OK. Then we'll go for the real time settings, and here we'll select performance mode and OK. So in this video, we have created a ball bearing assembly using the Creo Parametric software. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, then please hit on the like button, share it, and subscribe to this channel, CADCAM C Tutorials. Thanks.